अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? एज यू नो स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर स्टडीइंग चैप्टर नंबर 8 इलेक्ट्रोकेमिस्ट्री इन द लास्ट वीडियो. सो आई एक्सप्लेन्ड अबाउट डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रो डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ द सब्सटेंसेस दैट वर क्लासिफाइड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ पासिंग इलेक्ट्रिसिटी दैट वर नेम्ड एज इलेक्ट्रोलाइट्स विच कैन अलाउ टू पास इलेक्ट्रिसिटी थ्रू दैम. और द सेकेंड वन इज़ the known electrolyte that were termed as on the basis of to not allow to pass electricity through them. Yes students, one phenomena we also studied in the last video, that was the Faraday law. He explained that the amount of any substance that was liberating at any electrode during the electrolysis is directly proportional to the quantity of current passed through the electrolyte, which are the conductors. In last video, I was explaining in detail about the electrolyte, non-electrolyte and the phenomenon of electrolysis. That was according to the scientists the mass which is deposited on the electrode, that was directly proportional, means when we pass or when we increase the amount of electricity, so deposited mass of the electrolyte will also be increased. Or if we lower down the amount of electricity, so the deposited mass will also be lower down. So that was studied in the first video. Now today I am going to start the explanation about the second law of electrolysis that was also proposed by the scientist Michael Faraday in the same chapter. So this assignment means assignment number 2 is the continued assignment of the first assignment. As you have completed in your copies, then from the same page you will have to start the same work from the same page. Okay students, in my first video I was explaining about the phenomenon of electrolysis through an electrolyte, in which I showed you the diagram of electrolytic apparatus in which an electrolyte is filled, and when electrolysis is conducted or continued, or you can say that when the electrolysis is occurred through the substance of electrolyte, then what will be happened at the electrode. So I explained that the positive charge or the negative charge will be migrated towards their respective poles, you saw the phenomena that the respective charged particles were moving towards the respective terminals. Okay, so today the same phenomena I am going to explain that was explained or performed by the scientist Michael Faraday. In the first experiment he used only the single electrolyte, and he repeated the same experiment by using the different electrolytes and by passing the same amount of current within the same time. So he saw that the same thing is that the masses of different substances deposited or liberated when same quantity of current is passed through different electrolytes connected in series are proportional to their chemical equivalent masses. Okay, the same thing is that you observed here that scientists took more than one electrolytic cell. In my first video I shown you the only one electrolytic cell, but here you are looking at the figure that here scientists used the more than one electrolytic cell just to see the phenomenon of electrolysis. So he connected three different electrolytic cell in a series with each other, and as you see that different electrolytes are filled in the different electrolytic cell. In the first cell he put silver nitrate solution, in the second container he used copper sulfate solution, and in the third vessel he filled aluminum nitrate solution. So here I have written aqueous along with the ion, both of the ions, and here you can see that I have also written aqueous with both of the ions, and in the third case I have written aqueous in both of the ions. What does it mean? It means that whenever dissociation occurs while passing electricity, then ionic compound dissociates into their ions like positive or negative. So they will be remain in aqueous form until the current is passing through the solution. okay? So when they will get deposit at the respective terminals or the respective poles, then they will get solid in the neutral state. Okay, so scientists ने यहाँ पर क्या किया कि तीन different electrolytes उन्होंने use किए और इन तीनों different electrolytes में से इन तीनों को एक दूसरे के साथ connect करके एक phenomenon study किया. एक उनके जहन में कन्फ्यूजन थी कि अगर एक जैसे फर्स्ट टाइम उन्होंने एक इलेक्ट्रोलाइटिक सेल से उन्होंने करंट पास करके इस चीज़ को ऑब्जर्व किया कि जितना ज़्यादा करंट पास किया जाता है डिपॉजिट होने वाले अमाउंट भी उतना ज़्यादा होता है सब्सटेंस का. सिमिलरली उन्होंने ये चीज़ ऑब्जर्व की कि अगर एक से ज़्यादा इलेक्ट्रोलाइट यूज़ किया जाए और करंट की अमाउंट और टाइम की क्वांटिटी अगर सेम रखी जाए तो क्या डिपॉजिट होने वाले मास पर कोई फ़र्क पड़ेगा. ये चीज़ देखने के लिए उन्होंने डिफरेंट इलेक्ट्रोलाइट्स यूज़ किए और एक ही वक्त में, यानी टाइम उन्होंने कॉन्स्टेंट रखा और अमाउंट ऑफ करंट जो उन्होंने इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज इस बैटरी के थ्रू पास किया वो भी उन्होंने सेम रखा. इस अमाउंट को उन्होंने नाम दिया लाइक उन्होंने जो अमाउंट पास किया था इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज का वो था 96,500 कोलम. तो ये चूंकि फैराडे ने यूज़ किया था अमाउंट इन वन सेकेंड सो दैट वाज कॉल्ड एज द वन फैराडे. ओके, सो दिस अमाउंट ऑफ कोलम और द कोलम इज़ द यूनिट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज. सो दिस मच अमाउंट ऑफ कोलम वॉज पास बाय फैराडे सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज द फैराडे और वन फैराडे कंटेन 96,500 कोलम. अकॉर्डिंग टू द स्टेटमेंट आई टोल्ड यू दैट के द मैसेज ऑफ डिफरेंट सब्सटेंसेज डिपॉजिटेड वैन सेम क्वान्टिटी ऑफ करंट इज पास थ्रू डिफरेंट इलेक्ट्रोलाइट्स कनेक्टेड इन सीरीज आर प्रोपोर्शनल टू देयर केमिकल इक्विवेलेंट मासेस. ओके, तो यहाँ पर देखिए कि मासेस का जो वर्ड है मैंने पहले भी यूज़ किया था कि जब हम फर्स्ट लॉ हम स्टडी कर रहे थे तो वहाँ पर भी ये चीज़ सामने आई थी कि जितने ज़्यादा टाइम तक करंट पास किया जाता है, जितने ज़्यादा टाइम के लिए जितना ज़्यादा अमाउंट करंट पास किया जाता है डिपॉजिट होने वाले सब्सटेंस का मास भी उतना ही ज़्यादा होता है. तो सिमिलर यहाँ पर भी साइंटिस्ट ने यही चीज़ ऑब्जर्व की कि जितना ज़्यादा अमाउंट करंट का पास किया जाएगा तो डिपॉजिट होने वाले सब्सटेंस का मास भी उतना ही ज़्यादा होता है बट दैट इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द केमिकल इक्विवेलेंट मासेस. साइंटिस्ट ने यहाँ पर एक न्यू टर्मिनोलॉजी इंट्रोड्यूस करवाई दैट इज केमिकल इक्विवेलेंट मासेस. सो व्हाट इज इट केमिकल इक्विवेलेंट मासेस क्या होता है. केमिकल इक्विवेलेंट मासेस इज ईजिली बी कैलकुलेटेड बाई डिवाइडिंग एटोमिक मासेस ऑफ द एलिमेंट विच इज डिपॉजिटेड ऑन द इलेक्ट्रोड बाई डिवाइडिंग of its valency. Okay, for example यहाँ पर उन्होंने एक formula propose किया कि how we can calculate the chemical equivalent masses. So chemical equivalent masses of any element can be calculated by dividing atomic mass of the element to their valencies of the element. Okay, so scientists, as you have seen that कि scientists used silver nitrate in first of the vessel and in the second electrolytic cell he used copper sulfate, in the third electrolytic cell he used aluminium nitrate. So we can see that कि deposit होने वाले जो substance का amount है वो अपने रिस्पेक्टिव पोल की तरफ जाएगा. ठीक है ना. अब जैसे यहाँ पर आप देख रहे हो कि सॉल्यूशन के अंदर सिल्वर नाइट्रेट अगर डिसोसिएट होता है तो सिल्वर पर कौन सा चार्ज आएगा. आफ्टर आयनाइजेशन इट विल गेट पॉजिटिव चार्ज एंड नाइट्रेट पर क्या चार्ज आएगा. इट विल गेट नेगेटिव चार्ज. तो ये अपने रिस्पेक्टिव पोल की तरफ माइग्रेट करना शुरू करेंगे और ये वहाँ पर जाकर डिपॉजिट रहेंगे. अब यहाँ पर देखिए कि सिल्वर का रिस्पेक्टिव पोल क्या है. सिल्वर इज डिपॉजिटेड over the cathode because its respective terminal is the negative pole, so it will migrate towards the negative terminal and it will get deposit over here to get neutralized. Okay, तो यहाँ पर आकर negative terminal के ऊपर आकर silver आकर deposit हो जाएगा और यहाँ पर अपना जो electron उसने lose किया था solution के अंदर वो यहाँ से दोबारा pick करेगा और neutral हो जाएगा. इस तरीके से हम ये चीज़ calculate कर सकते हैं कि कितना silver का amount आकर यहाँ पर deposit हुआ, कितना इसका मास कितना था, इसका केमिकल इक्विवेलेंट मास कितना था. तो ये चीज़ हम पहले कैलकुलेट साइंटिस्ट ने किया और उसके एग्जैक्टली उन्होंने जब वन फेराडे इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज पास किया इस कंटेनर में से देन ही गॉट द एग्जैक्टली मासेस. आई शो यू दैट ही हाउ ही कैलकुलेटेड द केमिकल इक्विवेलेंट मासेस. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल ही कैलकुलेट द मास ऑफ सिल्वर दैट वॉज द पॉजिटिव चार्जेस. ऑल ही कैलकुलेट ऑल द कैट आइंस एंड ही फाउंड द केमिकल इक्विवेलेंट मासेस बाई डूइंग दिस. नाउ ही कैलकुलेटेड वट वॉज द मास ऑफ लाइक फार्मूला आई टोल्ड यू अबाउट द फार्मूला दैट एटॉमिक मास ऑफ द एलिमेंट वॉज डिवाइडेड बाई द वैलेंसी. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी सी द एटॉमिक मास ऑफ सिल्वर दैट इज इक्वल टू 108 grams of the atomic mass of silver and its valency is plus 1. So plus 108 divided by 1, so we will get exactly 108 grams. ओके इट मींस दैट कि जब 1 फैराडे कोलम करंट पास किया जाता है या इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज पास किया जाता है तो फर्स्ट टाइम वी विल गेट द अमाउंट ऑफ डिपॉजिटेड सिल्वर दैट विल इक्वल टू 108 ग्राम्स. इन द नेक्स्ट कंटेनर देन ही कैलकुलेटेड द मास ऑफ कॉपर. व्हाट इज एटॉमिक मास ऑफ कॉपर दैट इज इक्वल टू 63.5 एंड व्हाट इज अ वैलेंसी ऑफ कॉपर दैट इज 2. So sometime in some reaction copper shows the variable valency, sometime it shows plus 1 or sometime it shows plus 2 valency, but here we are dividing by 2. We are considering the valency of copper is plus 2. So 63.5, that is the atomic mass of copper, will be divided by 2. So we will get exactly equal to 31.75 grams mass. So that is the chemical equivalent mass. Okay, so when we pass 1 Faraday electric charge through the electrolytic cell or through the electrolyte, so we will get 31.75 grams of copper that will be deposited at electrode, that is a cathode terminal. Okay, so next in the next vessel he calculated the mass of aluminium. That what is the atomic mass of aluminium? It is equal to 27 grams. And what is the valency of aluminium? So that is the 3. Okay, plus 3 is the valency. So when 27 will be divided by 3, then we will get the exact amount of 9 gram of aluminium. So that will be deposited over the cathode terminal. Okay, so in this way, he calculated that when 1 Faraday or 96,500 coulomb electric charge will be passed through silver nitrate, copper sulfate and aluminium nitrate solutions or electrolytes respectively, then he got exactly the amount of silver is equal to 108 grams, copper is equal to 31.75 grams and aluminium is equal to 9 grams. So this will be found or calculated by using this formula, that is a chemical equivalent masses. Okay students, so in this way we can explain that according to Faraday, when the amount of electric charge will be increased, then definitely the deposited mass will also be increased, or when the electric charge will be decreased, then the deposit mass will also be decreased. So by using this experiment, scientists prove that both are directly proportional to each other. Now students, come on your book and open your book, page number 126. Yes students, see 126 page number. Here the Faraday's second law of electrolysis is mentioned over here. So in the first line you can see that the statement is written over here, that you can copy down the statement from the book as it is, as I have shown you on the board. So if there is any kind of difficulty, you can watch the video and pause it now, then write the statement from the video, or you can use your book for writing the statement. Okay, or it is also mentioned in your given worksheet or assignment number 2, so you can copy down from there as you wish. That one is easy to you, then you can copy down from there. Okay, so here the statement is mentioned, then explanation is which I explained on the board. So the in the word explanation is also mentioned, the page number 126, and the diagram is over mentioned over here, but you will not draw the diagram in your copies, just you will write down the statement and explanation as I have given you in the worksheet. Okay students, now come on your second assignment, in which the question answers are continued from the first one. Two questions you have completed in your copies. Then in this assignment you will start from question number 3. So this is a continued assignment, as you know that I am telling again and again that is a continued of the chapter number 8, electrochemistry. So you will copy down the given following question answers after completing the first assignment in your chemistry copies.
then no need to make the title page once again. I am telling you again that this is a continuous assignment, so you will continue from the same page. Okay, so you will write down question number 3 first of all, that is a straight and explain Faraday's second law of electrolysis. So for this I have mentioned the reference over here. Okay, you will have to see the page number, that is 126. First, you will give the heading of Faraday's second law of electrolysis. Then you will write down the statement, or as I told you that you will copy down from the given assignment or from the board or from your book. It's totally up to you. Okay, from where you will feel easy. So you can copy down the statement first, then the explanation. Okay, then after explanation, you may copy down the formula to calculate the chemical equivalent masses of an element. And I told you that one Faraday contain how many coulombs? So one Faraday has 96,500 coulombs electric charge that was firstly passed through the electrolyte by Faraday. Through any electrolyte. I hope students saw that explanation was quite easy, or I tried to make it easy for you so that you were easily copy down and make sure that each and everything is clear for all of you. It must be crystal clear to all of you. I hope that. So students, you will have to copy down as it is. Okay, and now take care. Allah Hafiz.